Hello, Prosper High School. I'm Tanner Argyle.
And I'm Jack Purdy, and this is Eagle TV.
Everyone sees the talent in the Eagle band that performs at pep rallies and football games, but many people don't notice the hardworking individuals that lead the band to success. Kaylee Blevins has the story.
Drum majors, is the band ready? Now sit back and enjoy the mighty Eagle band.
Drum majors are the leaders of the band. They are the conductors.
One of the things that drum majors do us is correct marching, help them learn how to march.
We actually serve the band. I want to become drum major because, well, my brother is in band too, and going behind him has been hard.
From a really young age, I really wanted to be drum major just because I care a lot about band and music. To become a drum major, you have to go through an audition. You have to musically conduct in front of judges, and then you also have to teach how to march, and then you also have to go through an interview. Being a leader as a sophomore is tough.
Some of the upperclassmen in the band don't want to listen and take orders.
But in the end, it all works out. They accept you as a leader because you sacrifice a lot for them, and you do everything you can to make their experience the best.
With photographer Oli Zaklod, this is Kaylee Blevins reporting for Eagle TV.
Thank you to all the drum majors for contributing to our school spirit.
Last week, we had the privilege of seeing Coach Stanton in short shorts as he went on about his glory days. This week, Ms. Childs will take us back and share her experience as a high school student.
When I was in high school, Ms. Childs edition. Some of you may have Ms. Childs as a teacher in the classroom, but who was she in high school?
I was really involved. I was on the drill team. I was Lieutenant Beth Calloway. I was in student council. I think I was the treasurer or the secretary. I did PALS, which is the program where you go to the elementary schools and mentor little children. I was in TAFE, which is the Association of Future Educators. And here I am, I'm a teacher now. I was always really involved in the homecoming stuff. And we did the homecoming skits, and my junior year we did Peter Pan, and I got to be Wendy, so I ran around the gym screaming to be saved from the evil mascot from the other team. And then my senior year I was Sandy in the school skit, which was Grease, so that was really fun. I loved hanging out with everyone. I was friends with the band kids. I obviously hung out with my dance friends, but I dated the football quarterback, so I hung out with the athletes, but I was in all the AP classes, so I hung out with a bunch of smart people, and so I was very involved with every clique, even the ones that weren't involved, I probably was friends with because I was a really friendly person. So yes, I was every stereotype.
This is Tori Bowden and Hunter Jackson with Eagle TV.
Wow, Ms. Childs definitely was a well-rounded person in high school. Now, we bring you a story on that people that helped get the football team prepared for the game.
Throughout the year, the dedication of the sports medicine trainers helps keep the Prosper athletes healthy.
The majority of our activities actually are outside of the classroom. The inside of the classroom is basically for learning the basic skills, but we do all kinds of practices, especially during football season, every day before and after school, we're out there.
We try to do a lot of things that are fun for the kids as well as make them work. So,
if someone gets a sprain or something, we get to like learn how to treat it and we get to help the athlete get better.
Definite hands-on experience.
It takes a lot of dedication because we're here like all the time, you know, from sunup to sunset on Fridays and Thursdays for games. And, you know, if you have afternoon practice, you're here about 3 hours after school. If you have morning practice, you got to be up here at about 6 o'clock. So it takes quite a bit of dedication.
The more you practice, the better you'll be in a real situation.
It's a lot of fun. And if you guys know anybody who wants to be a student trainer, they can contact Coach Jones or Coach McNeil.
You can learn a lot and have a whole lot of fun along the way.
It's pretty fun.
It is a lot of fun. It's a lot of hard work, but it's worth it in the end.
Like our football team is a family on the field, so is the theater department that performed in the auditorium.
I love having an extracurricular activity, so it's fun.
If you are in the acting program, it helps you because you're learning to deal with people. You're learning to channel your emotions, bring up false emotions, so lying in essence, and it's fun. It's entertaining. It's that family atmosphere, literally become like friends for life.
I enjoy doing all the shows and participating in the class.
I like this program because we're like a family, kind of, because we spend so much time together that we kind of have to bond, otherwise it's not going to turn out well. So we're pretty close, I guess.
Now let's see what the technical side of theater has to offer.
If you took the technical program, obviously you're learning state-of-the-art equipment, lights, sound, things like that can you know, help you get a job in the real world.
I plan to pursue a career in acting, and I hope that the Prosper Theater program has prepared me for that.
This is Kristen Neal as reporter and Aaliyah Shulwood as photographer, signing off for EGLT.
You may have noticed the Keep Calm and Give Blood posters around school. They got me wondering where the Keep Calm phrase came from. Some Iyengar found the answer for me, and we all thought it was so interesting we wanted to share it with you. As we close this edition of Eagle TV, please enjoy the short video created by and used with permission of Barter Books. I'm Jack Purdy. See you next time.
And I'm Tanner Argyle. Stay classy, Eagles.
In the spring of 1939, during the build-up to war with Germany, the British government commissioned a series of propaganda posters. These posters were intended to offer the public reassurance in the dark days that lay ahead. They were required to be uniform in style and were to feature a special and handsome typeface, making them difficult for the enemy to counterfeit. They used the crown of King George VI as the only graphic device and had just two colours. Of the three final designs that went into production, the first poster carried the slogan, "Your courage, your cheerfulness, your resolution will bring us victory." The second poster had the words, "Freedom is in peril, defend it with all your might." But the third design, of which over 2.5 million posters were printed, simply read, "Keep calm and carry on." The first two designs were distributed in September of 1939 and appeared up and down the country in shop windows and railway platforms. But the Keep Calm posters were held in reserve, intended for use only in times of crisis or invasion. In the end, the poster was never officially issued, and it remained unseen by the public until a copy turned up more than 50 years later. It was found in a second-hand bookshop called Barter Books in the northeast corner of England. Barter Books was begun in 1991 by a couple, Stuart and Mary Manley. The building used to be an old Victorian railway station. Huge rows of stacked shelves now stand in the place where the tracks would have been, but the station's old tea rooms and waiting rooms are still there. It was in 2000 that Stuart found the poster in a box of dusty old books that had been bought at auction. Mary liked it so much she had it framed and put it up near the shop till, and it proved so popular with the customers that a year later they began to sell copies. Since that time, the poster has been reproduced, parodied, and trivialized, and has become a truly iconic image of the 21st century. It is hard to say exactly why such a phrase from a bygone decade would have so much appeal and resonance now. Its design is considered simple and timeless, and now commonly recognizable. However, it is perhaps the words on the poster that people find most enchanting. Like a voice out of history, it offers a very simple, warm-hearted message to inspire confidence in others during difficult times. And it's something that should never fade from fashion. To keep calm and carry on.